Hey, what is up? It's Mikey. We got ourselves yet another Destiny Weekly Nightfall Strike Guide. The Weekly Nightfall, that's the first thing you should do on Tuesday so that you get that 25% bonus that applies to all your activities. So this week we're going up against our favorite big purple enemy. Looks like he could be Vex, but he's part of the Fallen Sepix Prime. Let's get into the modifiers. We got epic, heavily shielded and highly aggressive enemies appear in greater numbers. This week's burn is arc. Arc damage from any source is greatly increased. Light switch, minions of the darkness deal much more melee damage, don't get smacked by them, and angry minions of the darkness won't flinch even after massive damage. So basically bring out all your blue weapons. I'm going to try out Song of Erdut. That's the new, that's the raid LMG. I got that. It worked all right. Patience of Time was a beast. Really nice sniper. Definitely bring that out. And Praetus Timepiece, Arc Primary. Love this thing. It did better than I thought. It's not even fully maxed out. So definitely bring that out if you have one. That's from the Vault of Glass. And yeah, I chose to be Gunslinger just because I like that super better. So once I head to the refinery, I just like to chill for a couple seconds. Be lazy and speed on through this whole area. I mean, you can fight these guys. It's not a big deal. But by now, everyone should know that once you get here, you can go ahead and head on to the pit. And this is where you're going to spend your time, maybe 95% of the time, just chilling this pit. Okay, now because they have that light switch modifier, the one where they have extra melee damage, you don't want to mess with these little invisible dudes. Okay, you get close, they will chase you. So, you know, don't overextend your reach right here. You walk out too far, they will chase you. Okay, you're not like totally invincible here. But that Patience of Time sniper is so good, especially against the Reaver captains with their big shields. Really good to have that if you do have it. Any arc sniper is going to do pretty good, actually. And just be aware of those snipers that are cloaked all the way in the back. Okay, so this part kind of tedious. Really nothing new here, just chill in the pit, kill all the dudes, kill all the things. Okay, so let's fast forward on to the Noble Devil Walker. And what I like to do first thing is take out my sniper and blow off his cannon. And he's pretty much going to be screwed. He's going to be useless. He's just going to sit there like a lump on a log. He's going to be like, duh, and not even attack you. Like, I don't even think he attacked me once I did that. At that point, once he loses his cannon, I just like to chill under the bridge, go left or right. Sometimes I'll hang on the right, depends on how the enemies are behaving. And you guys gotta know by now, once the walker's dead, you can just run on past all these guys. It's no big deal, because if they kill you, and they did kill me, you can just respawn and come on in. Respawns are allowed. So finally, we get to the big purple guy. We're in the Devil's Lair and at Sepix Prime. Kill all his worshippers or whatever it is they're doing. And after that, I like to just hide in my room like a little bitch. And we just sit here and snipe him. The Arc Sniper, I'm dealing 6,700 damage. It's awesome. I did pull out the Black Hammer. It didn't do so good. It dealt 3k. Yeah, you get those crits. The 3 crits in a row thing. But he moves around a lot, so I just want to get the show done and over with. Bring out the arc weapons. And here's another thing. See, this is where my gunslinger came in handy, because with that I could take down these noble shanks, okay? Because they're kind of annoying when they've got their solar shields up. So I used that and ended up bringing out my icebreaker. Icebreaker, it's always going to help. That way you get to, you know, refresh your ammo for that sniper, whatever one you're using. So lots of pop shots, you know, just ducking and diving. Really, there's no point in you leaving the room. You could just sit here the whole time. Really easy. I'm surprised they haven't patched this. Just stay in this room. Don't go down below, because that'll screw up the spawns or something like that. And that is pretty much it. Once it's done and over with, come on out to pick up the little Illuminati things, and you'll get ether seeds and house banners, and that's pretty much it. And what I get this week, I got another weapon I'm not going to use. Because now that I got this Praetith, that's a nice little legendary primer. I like that. What did you guys get this week? Leave a comment below. By the way, every time there's a reset, I do the Destiny live streams with the viewers. I do the Nightfall. I do the weekly. We do the raids. So that'll probably be today and tomorrow. If you want to play, add me on Twitter, Facebook, Twitch. If you want, just follow me on Twitch. Links down below. Please take 3 seconds, write the video. I see you next. All right, so on the left side there, we had an update recently to Destiny. I talk about the changes. You can click on the screen or link down below. It's just a little patch note video. And on the right side, we have the weekly podcast, Game Lounge 78. We talk about Destiny and all the stuff that happened in gaming. We talk about the Paris events. We talk about bullies. We talk about douchebags. Talk about cool people. And, you know, it's just random. I don't remember all the stuff, but I know it's a good podcast. So you can click on the screen, or there's a link down below, or there's an iTunes, or there's a Spreaker. There's all kinds of ways. Check it out.